Hey guys, Tanmay here, back with another video for our channel Simple Snippets. This is the second video for our playlist Network Security Concepts, Algorithms and Protocols. This video is a continuation of the previous video and this too is going to be more theoretical and conceptual video. If you haven't seen the first video, have a look at it as it will clear some basic concepts of network security. So as the name suggests, we are going to be looking at the principles of network security and the concept of cryptography. Okay, so let's get started with today's topic. So today we're going to be learning some principles of network security that needs to be taken into consideration when we implement the network security over the network. We're also going to learn the concept of cryptography and see a basic example of how it works. So there are a few principles of network security which needs to be taken into consideration when implementing network security efficiently. Following are the principles of network security: confidentiality, authentication, integrity, non-repudiation, access control, and availability. So let's take a closer look at all these principles. The principle of confidentiality. This principle specifies that only the sender and intended recipient should be able to access the contents of a message. Confidentiality gets lost or compromised if an unauthorized person is able to access a message. Interception attacks usually cause loss of confidentiality. So as shown in the diagram, there are two users, Alice and Bob, having a conversation, while an invalid user, Tom, intercepts their conversation. This causes loss of confidentiality, since Bob and Alice don't want their message to be read by any third person. Now let's have a look at the principle of authentication. Authentication mechanism helps establish proof of identities. This process ensures that the origin of an electronic message or document is correctly identified. For example, if Alice and Bob want to have a conversation, but this third fellow, Tom, disguises himself as Alice and talks to Bob. Now, due to lack of authentication, Bob has no idea that he is talking to Tom. In this case, the principle of authentication is defeated. Now, let's have a look at the principle of integrity. When the contents of a message are changed after the sender sends it, but before it reaches the intended recipient, we say that the integrity of the message is lost. Modification attacks usually cause loss of integrity. As shown in the example, Alice wants to transfer $100 to Tom's account, but Tom alters the transaction and transfers $200 in his account by modifying the transaction's amount, thus losing the message integrity. Now let's have a look at the principle of non-repudiation. There are situations when a user sends a message and later on refuses that she sent that message. The principle of non-repudiation defeats such possibility of denying something having done it. That means non-repudiation does not allow the sender of a message to refute the claim of not sending that message. For example, Alice could send a fund transfer request to bank over the internet. After the bank performs the fund transfer as per Alice's instruction, she could claim that she never sent the fund transfer instruction to the bank. Thus, Alice repudiates or denies her fund transfer instruction. Let's have a look at the principle of access control. The principle of access control determines who should be able to access what. Access control is broadly related to role management and rule management. Role management concentrates on the user side, while rule management focuses on resources side. For example, we have two users, Alice and Tom. Alice is admin and Tom is a normal user. So admin should be able to access the database and Tom should not be able to access the database. Access control mechanism ensures such functionality. Let's have a look at the principle of availability. The principle of availability states that resources should be available to authorized parties at all times. Interruption attacks usually put the availability of resources in danger. For example, due to intentional actions of an unauthorized user Tom, an authorized user Alice may not be able to contact the bank servers for certain services. So now that we've understood the principles of network security and why they are important, let's have a look at the concept of cryptography. Before I tell you the theoretical definition, I'll give you an example by showing a simple scenario with our favorite Alice, Bob and Tom characters. So here's the scene. Alice and Bob wants to communicate with each other. Now this time, Alice and Bob are smart enough to know that there could be a third person listening to their conversation over the network. She wants to send a confidential message, say for example ABC. She replaces each alphabet of the text that lies two places ahead of the characters. That is, A is replaced with C, B is replaced with D, and C is replaced with E. Now this process is called encryption. We assume that Bob knows this technique in this case. After applying this technique, Alice converts the plain text to what we call as ciphertext. She sends the ciphertext over the network, and as usual, our third character Tom captures this message. He gets CDE and thinks he's got something confidential, whereas that's not the original message. So sorry Tom, this time you ain't getting rich. Meanwhile, as the message reaches Bob, he replaces each character with two positions preceding to the current position of the character to get the original message ABC. Now this process is called decryption. So in a very simple and crude way, we achieved a confidentiality as message was safely transferred between the valid and legitimate users. Now here's the theoretical definition of cryptography and some terms associated with it. Cryptography is the art of achieving security by encoding messages to make them non-readable. This sounds complicated, right? It's not. It's the same thing that Alice and Bob just did in the example that I showed you. Clear text or plain text signifies a message that can be understood by the sender, the recipient, and also anyone who gets an access to that message. When plain text is codified using any suitable scheme, the resulting message is called ciphertext, and it is readable only to those who know the encoding and decoding process of that particular scheme. Encryption is the process of converting plain text to ciphertext using some encoding scheme. Decryption is the process of converting ciphertext back to plain text using a decoding scheme. Now, depending on how the plain text is converted to ciphertext, there are two techniques. First, substitution technique. In this technique, the characters of plain text are replaced by other characters, numbers, or symbols. The second technique is transposition technique. Here the plain text characters are itself scrambled in a certain pattern to get the ciphertext. For example, in this case, the characters A, B, C, D are replaced with numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is an example of substitution, as those characters are replaced by other symbols or numbers. Let's take an example of transposition techniques. Here the characters A, B, C, D are swapped and you get a ciphertext which is B, A, D, C. So the consecutive positions, that is A, B is swapped to B, A and C, D is swapped as D, C. So this is an example of transposition technique. So that's it for this video guys. In the next video, we'll start learning some practical cryptographic algorithms and study its working. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Do let me know your reviews and suggestions by dropping some comments. Also make sure you subscribe to our channel as you'll get notified when we upload the next video. Peace.